103:8-12. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in love. He will not always accuse, nor will he harbor his anger forever. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgression from us. Verse 8 to 9 speak about the character of the Lord. Amen po ba? And the remaining verse po tells us about what this holy and loving God did to us. Mga kapatid, have you ever experienced po yung feeling na hindi po tayo makalapit sa Panginoon dahil po sa mga kasalanan nating nagawa? Or the enemy keeps on reminding us ng ating pong mga nakaraan that we are not worthy sa paningin at presensya ng Panginoon. Pero sabi po dito, He is compassionate and gracious. Grace is the blessing that we don't deserve. Pero because of God's love and compassion, there are things that we deserve. Pero hindi po inaalaw ng ating Panginoon na mangyari sa atin. Yun po yung kaparusahan sa ating mga kasalanan. In verse 12, for as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is His love for those who fear Him. The height po or distance ng pagitan ng langit at lupa. Ganun po hinahalin tulad yung pagmamahal ng Diyos para sa bawat isa. And understanding all of this gives us the joy and gratitude to worship and glorify Him. Kaya naman po, samahan niyo po ako. May I invite everyone to please stand up and join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you po, Panginoon, sa kabutihan mo, Lord God, sa oras na to, Lord God, na kami pong mga anak mo, Panginoon, ay may pagkakataon at oportunidad, Panginoon, na Ikaw, Panginoon, ay maitaas sa aming kalagitnaan. Lord, Ikaw po ang aming Diyos na buhay, Panginoon, na kumikilos sa buhay ng bawat isa. Salamat po, Panginoon, sa paglilinis mo sa aming mga kasalanan. At salamat din po, Panginoon, sa pagpapala at sa pagpapalo na patuloy po naming nararanasan, Lord God. Sa ganun malakaran po namin, Panginoon, ang aming paniniwala sa iyo, Panginoon. Salamat po, Lord. We also lift up in prayer, Lord God. Pastora Ann, Panginoon. Anoint her, Panginoon. And kumilos apo, Panginoon, ang iyong banal na Espiritu, Panginoon, sa laaming kalagitnaan. Ang lahat po ng gagamitin mo, Lord God, Panginoon, ay magbigay ng kuluguran, Panginoon, tanging sa pangalan mo lamang. Sa iyo po namin ibinabalik, Panginoon, ang pinakamataas na papuri, pagsamba, Panginoon. As we say, we love you, Father, we love you, Jesus, and we love you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Grace today. God in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Our Father, hear us from heaven, forgive our sins, we pray. Hear our song as it rises to heaven. May your glory fill the earth as the waters cover the sea.
Proverbs 3, verse 5 to 6, it says, commit your way to the Lord, trust in Him, and He will act.
I can do it.
impossible.
Solve in my heart.
be weak, but your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, but my God, you never will. I may be weak, but your spirit's strong in me.
Church! Hallelujah! Sabi mo nga sa katabi mo, nothing is impossible with God for those who believe and trust in Him. Sabi nga doon sa Psalms, He is a compassionate and gracious God. Amen? Yan po ang Diyos na pinapanampalataya po natin. At andito po siya ngayon, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. Praise God po. And this month of our series, it's about the faith and trust, inseparable matter of the heart. So now we are in the third part. But sabi, di ba, yung na-learn natin, without faith, it's impossible to please God. This is an important learning from God's message to us from the previous preaching that we heard. And then say it to me nga, I want to please God. Amen. So, pleasing God is very essential to an abundant life. Sino pa gustong guminhawa ang buhay dito? Amen, di ba? Then, we should obey His command. In faith. Tandaan po natin, in faith. And He is more than faithful. Those who are faithful. Kaya kapatid, pag faithful ka pala kay Lord, mas faithful ang Panginoon sa iyo. Amen. So, sa ating mga Kristiyano, na mula sa puso, sabi nga ni Papi lagi sa atin, no? Papi always reminding us, mula sa puso, hindi sa nguso. Building our faith is a natural step. Ang pagtatag ng ating pananampalataya, ang ating patuloy na nanaisin. Yun yung always nating dinidesire sa puso natin. Today, we are living in the world where temptation to doubt God. It's always keeping and knocking in our hearts. Di pa po ba? Marami tayong mga doubts, marami tayong mga tanong. At ito po talaga ay nakaka-attempt na maramdaman ng bawat isa. Bakit nga ba? Dahil nga po ba sa iyong mga challenges, ang iyong mga problema sa buhay? Bilang anak niya, or as His children, we need more than ever na tayo po yung mag-trust or magtiwala sa Panginoon. Even ano pa ang dumating na pagsubok sa buhay natin. Amen. Amen. So, previously, Pastora Sarah shared about the great faith of the Roman centurion. At ulitin ko po yung kanyang formula. Sino po ba nakakatanda nun? Memorize po ba nila? Sabi doon, di ba? Faith plus humility plus trust plus obedience equals miracle. Amen. Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. And last Saturday naman, Pastora Jen tackled an unwavering faith. Gaano nga ba katatag? Diba kanina tinanong ko, gaano po ba katatag ang iyong pananampalataya sa ating Diyos na buhay? And today, I want to share with you on how to respond to the love of God. I have entitled today's message, Love, Strong Foundation of Faith, and a Heart that Honors and Values Jesus. Ang tanong, meron ba tayo nito? Do we have this ba, kapatid? And in our anchor verse, in Luke 7, verse 47, sabi doon, therefore, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has shown, but whoever has been forgiven little, loves little. So let's pray. Let's bow our head. Thank you, Father God, for this day, Lord God. Salamat po, Panginoon, for your compassionate and gracious heart, Lord. Lord, illuminate to us, O God, your message today as we listen carefully, Lord God. Lord, give us, O Lord God, our heart, Lord God, to learn and to meditate your word, Lord God. Salamat po, Panginoon, and Lord, as your mouthpiece, Lord God, hide me, Lord God, behind your cross. And I humble myself, Lord God, before you. Salamat po, Panginoon, for this opportunity today, Lord God, to stand before you, Lord. And all of this, O Lord God, we give it back to you, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So, before we will read our scripture, so let's take a look first of the main characters here in the story. So, sino-sino po ba ang mga nandito sa storyang ito? First is Jesus Christ, the sinful woman, and Simon the Pharisee. So this event happened in the house of Simon the Pharisee. So there are other similar incident with other gospel from Matthew, Mark, and John. But here, if we read in Luke 7, verse 18 and onwards, that even John the Baptist doubted Jesus. And he even sent his disciples to ask Jesus to confirm if he is the Messiah. So they are still waiting. They've been waiting. At naghihintay pa rin sila na baka meron pang iba. Ikaw kapatid, naghihintay ka pa rin ba na may darating pang iba? Oh, di ba? Still waiting. Then we read read how Jesus affirmed that there is no greater than John the Baptist. So, grabe si Lord, ano? Nag-doubt na sa kanya si John the Baptist. Pero si Lord, he still acknowledged John the Baptist. Kaya kung nagda-doubt ka kay Lord, tanggap ka pa rin niya, kapatid. Tanggap pa rin niya tayo. So just do not wallow in doubts because that will be no use. Lalo pa nating patatagin yung ating faith or ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon. So sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo, kilala tayo ni Lord. So might as well kilalanin din natin siya. Amen. So napaka-exciting nitong topic na ito. Sino ba excited? Parang tulog pa lahat. Exciting, di ba? So itong topic na to ay yung si Simon the Pharisee. Hindi po yung Simon the Peter na yung apostle na kasama sa na disciples ni Jesus Christ. So Simon the Pharisee. So Simon the Pharisee invited Jesus Christ to his home. Then I will walk through you through the passage. So sabay-sabay po natin basahin. In Luke chapter 7, 36 to 50, this titles Jesus anointed by a sinful woman. So, when one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have a dinner with him, he went to the Pharisee's house and reclined at the table. A woman in that town who lived a sinful life learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house. So she came there with an alabaster jar perfume. As she stood behind him at his feet weeping, she began to wet his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. Do you remember yung a woman who caught in adultery? Amen. So, whom Jesus did not condemn. Hindi po kinondemn ni Jesus Christ yung adulterous woman na yon. Some scholars says that this was Mary Magdalene. Some describe she is a prostitute. So let me tell you about dun sa kwentong ito. Sa John 8, verse 10 to 11. So doon natin makikita yung story na ito, yung nagtanong si Jesus Christ sa adulterous woman na walang bumatok sa kanya. Sabing ganito, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither do I condemn you," Jesus declared. "Go now and live your life of sin." Go now and live your life of sin. So this woman who lived in a sinful life learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house. So dali-dali siyang pumunta with this alabaster perfume. So, itong scene na to, makikita nyo, if you will read this passage, ang ginawa nung babae, she really kneeled down, di ba? Dun sa bandang likod ng upuan ni Jesus Christ. And yung luha niya, pinanlinis niya sa paa ng Panginoong Jesus. In fact, ang dumi po ng mga paa ng mga tao noon before because wala naman sasakyan. Di ba? Wala rin sapatos. Puro sinyelas. Wala, Sandals. They said sandals. So, madumi yung paa ni Jesus Christ dahil lakad sila na lakad sa buong desierto. Okay? At yung mismong buhok niya ang ipinatuyo niya sa paa ni Jesus Christ. At pagkatapos nun, hinalikan niya ang paa ng kanyang Savior. At nilagyan po niya ito ng pabang. Ang tanong, bakit niya ginagawa yon? So sobrang humility ang kailangan upang magawa natin yon. Di po ba? Dahil yun po yung pinaka-lowest position or yung pinaka-mababang uri ng tao noon, yan ang ginagawa. So ano ba ang nagawa ni Jesus sa kanya? At ganito na lang niya ito karespeto at kamahal. What Jesus did for her, why she really love and has a great respect to Jesus Christ. So let's continue with the story. In verse 39, when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, "If this man were a prophet, he would know who is touching him and what kind of woman she is a sinner." Wow. Diba? Judgmental. Judgmental ka ba? Maka-judge, diba? Sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo, huwag tayong judgmental, kapatid. Bawal yun. Meron po bang nananampalataya na judgmental? Sabihin, nagkamali lang. Naku, born again pa naman yun. Diba? Pag hindi nagkaintindihan, hindi nagkasundo dun sa pinag-usapan, sabihin mo, born again ka pa naman, kapatid. Diba? Judgmental. Tapos, hindi lang kapareho ng pananampalataya natin or hindi natin ka-level ng faith. Sabihin natin, ay, sa impyerno pupunta yan. Grabe, no? So, instead na mahalin natin sila, di ba? Instead na i-imitate natin how Jesus loved us so that they will see Jesus in us. Sabihin mo nga ulit sa katabi mo, huwag judgmental at makasalanan. Okay? Huwag tayong judgmental dahil makasalanan din tayo. Amen. So in verse 40-46, basahin po ulit natin, Jesus answered him, "Simon, I have something to tell you." "Tell me, teacher," he said. "Two people owe money to a certain moneylender. One owe him 500 denarii and the other 50. Neither of them had the money to pay him back. So he forgave the debts of both. Now, which of them will love him more?" Simon replied, "I suppose the one who had bigger debts forgiven." "You have judged correctly," Jesus said. Then he turned toward the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? I came into your house. You did not give me water for my feet, but she wet my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You did not give me a kiss, but this woman, from time I entered, has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not put oil on my head, but she has poured perfume on my feet. So here, Simon did not show respect to Jesus like the sinful woman did. Sa ating mga babae, no, ang crown of glory natin ang ating buhok. Andiyan pa yung parang pupunta ka pa sa salon, magpapariband ka, papakeratin, di ba? Di ba? Magpapabangs. Depende sa aking bangs. So, but that glory was given to Jesus. Amen. So during those time, inviting someone to one's home is a gesture of friendship. But clearly, that was not Simon's intention. So like the other self-righteous Pharisees, he just wanted to catch Jesus to make mistake. And this Simon the Pharisee is also a prominent or famous na tao that time. So, green invite niya si Jesus Christ just to, siguro kung may YouTube before, no? Nag-collaborate sila. Marami sigurong like and views. So, that's only his intention. So, he did not do any ceremonial of hospitality. So, greeting the invited guests with a kiss, it shows hospitality on that time. But Simon nga, sabi, hindi niya ginawa. Even, kahit meron siyang servant or mga helper, he did not ask them to wash Jesus' feet. So, he did not show any generosity. But Simon did not give anything to our Lord Jesus Christ. But he only thinking about himself. Yung kanyang sarili. Self-righteous. So even pouring a fragrant oil on the head of the invited guests is a sign of honoring the guests. Katulad pa rin, hindi pa rin ginawa ni Simon. So you can see how hypocrite Simon was. Kunyari, ay kaibigan niya at nirerespeto niya si Jesus, pero hindi pala. So in this generation, do we really respect, honor, and love Jesus? So merely going to church for attendance is not really entirely honoring Jesus. Hello? It's going to church bringing with us a heart of gratitude and a song of praise and worship. So, dapat laging galing sa puso. Hindi lang tipo sa uso. And it's like yung alabaster jar, kung natatandaan nyo po, was poured on head of Jesus that reaches the heavenly throne and presence of God. So, in that manner, God was please, dun sa ginawa ng sinful woman. Kaya sabi mo kapatid sa iyong katabi, huwag na tayo malilate. Huwag na tayo malilate. Para, di ba pagtingin niyo po dito, unang-una pong mangyayari, di ba, sa ating program, ay ang pag-worship sa Panginoon. Eh, paano late? Hindi ka na nakapag-worship. Late na. So merely listening to the message but not really trying to understand. So we may live, it's also a sign of disrespect to His words. Kahit nga yung patulog-tulog, di ba ang lamig? Habang may nagpipreach. Pero sa amin, hindi na yun ang importante eh. Alam niyo po kung ano yung importante doon. Is yung pagrespeto doon sa word ng Panginoon. Amen. Palakpakan po natin ang Lord. Kaya sabihin mo, katabi mo, hoy, gising. Gising na. So ang tanong, bakit kaya nagawa ng makasalanang babae yung para kay Jesus Christ? Nagawa niya ito sa sobrang pasasalamat sa kabutihan at pagmamahal ni Jesus sa kanya. Amen. Ganun din po ba kayo? Amen. So una, iniligtas siya sa kamatayan. Yung walang bumato sa kanya at yung hindi niya kinondem itong sinful woman. So, kapatid, tayo ba ramdam natin ang pagmamahal ni Jesus? Ramdam mo ba, kapatid? Ano ba yung huling ginawa ng Panginoon sa'yo? Amen. Di ba ginising po tayo ngayong umagang ito? At marami po sa atin na hindi na po nagising. So, kailan mo naramdaman ang pagmamahal ni Jesus kahit ano pa man ang kasalanan na nagawa natin? Amen. Or baka katulad din ni Simon the Pharisee na mapagkunwari lamang. Huwag ganon, kapatid. So let's continue. Gising na po ba? Praise God. Sabi niya sa verse, sabi sa 47, verse 47-50, "Therefore, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has shown, but whoever has been forgiven, little loves little." Then Jesus said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." The other guests began to say among themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" Jesus said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." Amen. So noong niligtas ng Panginoon itong sinful woman sa pagbabato sa kanya para patayin siya. Yung tanong ni Jesus Christ sa kanya na, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither do I condemn you." Jesus declared, "Go now and live your life of sin." So here sa ating binabasa ngayon, hindi pa siya nakakatanggap ng pagpapatawad ni Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ just let her know to go and live your life or live in a righteous life. Amen? So here, ipapakita ni Jesus Christ sa atin that we are more valuable than of our mistakes. Amen? and what we will do with this truth. So the sinful woman approached Jesus with all humility and respect. She obeyed Jesus when she was commanded, "Go now and live your life of sin." Kasi pag hindi niya ito sinunod, hindi niya kayang humarap sa Panginoon the way she did. Amen? Kayo po ba, pag yung nag-disobey ba tayo, di ba ang hirap lumapit? Di ba ang sakit-sakit sa heart na, "Lord, paano po ba mag-pray ulit?" It's not very easy to us to go back to Him when our lives ay makasalanan. And here, we will see na ang sabi sa kanya ni Jesus Christ, "Your sins are forgiven." Praise God! So dahil dun sa kanyang respeto, pag-honor sa Panginoon, malaya niyang ginawa dahil she is free of sin. Diba? If we are free of sin, madali tayong lumapit sa Panginoon. Madali tayong maglambing, di ba? Madali tayong humingi ng, "Lord, baka naman." Di ba, Rose? Yes. Amen. So anong nakita ni Jesus doon sa sinful woman? Jesus felt yung sincerity and love sa kanya. Ganun din po ang nararamdaman ng Panginoong Jesus sa atin. When we repent, yung paglapit sa kanya with a humble heart. Amen? So sabihin mo nga sa sarili mo at sa katabi mo, "Sana all." Di ba? Sana all. So here, Jesus saw her heart. Nakikita po ng Panginoon ang puso ng bawat isa. So, what kind of a heart do God look for that will please Him? Ano pong klaseng puso ang hinahanap ng Panginoon sa atin to please Him? So, God looks for a heart that, letter H, honors Him with all of our heart. Amen? Honors Him with all of our heart. So, in Deuteronomy 6, verse 6, 5 to 6, "Love the Lord your God with all of your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts." Amen. So, you see how the sinful woman honor our God, our Savior Jesus Christ. And honoring God with our time, with our talents, and treasures is really pleasing to Him. Amen? So yung time natin, imbes na pumunta tayo, di ba, sa mga places na gusto nating puntahan, then bago tayo mag-attend ng worship, di ba? I mean, dapat bigay natin yung time natin muna sa Kanya. Yeah? Seek ye first. Tama. And talents. Sino po dito? Ayan, marami po tayong mga ministry, right? Ating mga media team, right? Our praise and worship team, palakpakan po natin sila. Praise and thank God because God is bringing all of these talents in our church family. And if you have that talent, kapatid, if you can sing, if you can dance, if you can preach like this, God is well pleased, right? And of course, your treasures, yung ating mga tithes and love offerings. So, mas magandang unahin po natin ang Panginoon. Amen. Lalong-lalo na sa ganitong ating mga finances. And yung meron tayo sa ACCI family, yung about how to honor God. Sino pong nakakatanda nun? Honor. Amen. Highest priority belongs to God alone. And O? Obedience to the highest level. Amen. And N? Not to sin, not to Satan. And O? Open to be a witness in words and in deed. And R? Reverent fear of God. So, bakit ba lagi natin itong inuulit-ulit? Dahil po, importante. Katulad ng kung paulit-ulit din tayo nagkakasala, ay paulit-ulit din po natin sinasaktan yung damdamin ng Panginoong Jesus. Kaya, we need to honor Him with all of our heart. Amen? Amen. So, E, entrust our life with Him in all of our heart. Entrust our life with Him with all of our heart. Sabi sa Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, all po all, hindi yung half. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. Amen? So, to submit to Him is to seek and obey His words. So, to seek and obey His words, makikita natin dito yung kanyang mga commands. Diba? Sabi ko nga kanina about our tithes and love offerings. Diba? Pag nasik natin yung kanyang word, we will obey His command in terms of our tithes and love offerings. We entrusted our life or our means or our resources because galing yun sa Kanya. Yes, sometimes we struggle, but we need really to entrust everything to Him. Kasi nga sabi, in all your ways, di ba? Submit to Him. So, before, I'm really struggling. I'm struggling in giving and my tithes and love offering. But when the time I really entrust to God, and that's the time I really give that love, the tithes and love offering to the Lord. And sabi nga, we honor Him in everything. Amen? And letter A, acknowledge from our heart our sins before God. Acknowledge from our heart our sins before God. So In 1 John 1:8, if we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. So it takes a deep searching of the heart and deep humility for us to do this. Sino sa inyo dito na sabihin, ako makasalanan ako, di ba? Parang ang hirap sabihin. But if we acknowledge in our heart that we sin before God, as the sinful woman did, he asked the Lord for forgiveness. And always check our heart, kapatid. Always check our heart. We should not be deceived. We need to accept that Jesus will forgive our sins. And we need to be humble enough before Him. Huwag tayo mapagmataas, kapatid. Dahil ang binababa ng tao ay tinataas ang Panginoon. Amen. And in R, God looks for our heart that, in letter R, remove pride from our hearts. So Psalms 139, verse 23 to 24, search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in a way everlasting. So pride causes significant damage to our faith by challenging our trust in God. So, before I was a sinful woman, I was full of myself. I really avoid to go to church because I thought those church people will only judge me. But when I started to attend Akad Family pa noon, ang ACCI, I did not feel that I was judged, but rather I was loved. Amen. Sino po dito yung nakaramdam ng ganun feeling when they entered in this church? They really welcome. You feel the presence of the Lord in this place when you attend this family. Amen. Papi knows my testimony. Kahit yung iba dito, mga pilintao. And he accepted me for who I was. Just like how Jesus accepted me. So, there was even a time when I was... when for one reason and another, which I cannot remember, because I naging lukewarm ako. I started lukewarm. Pero hindi ako sinukuan ni Papi. Ganun din po si Lord. Hindi po rin kayo susukuan. Amen. And Papi trusted me. And this made me who I am now. Standing before you and preaching the God's word. Hindi po madali. Pero ang sabi nga, with all of our heart, We need to be excited and obedience nga to the highest level. Amen. So, katulad ng sinful woman, ang sabi niya ulit, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. Yung kapayapaan na yon sa ating lahat, when you really give your life to God and remove all the pride in your heart, you're allowing God to enter into your heart. And God will change our heart. A heart with humility. A heart with a gesture of praising Him. Sino po dito still nahihiya pa rin to put their hands up to trust the Lord, to worship Him? Let the Lord fill your heart, kapatid, as what I felt right now. Remove that pride, kapatid. Nakikita niyo po, ang daming vacant seats. Asan na kaya yung iba? Are they offended? Do they have their pride still in their heart? Why they are not here? Are there still feeling unforgiven? They're still not forgive themselves? Kapatid, ikaw yung nakaupo kayo dyan at dun po sa ating mga nanonood. Tulungan po natin yung mga kapatid nating nawala. Katulad ng ginawa ni Papi na hindi po ako sinukuan. To bring back that one soul to the feet of Jesus Christ. Amen. And I really give glory to our loving, living God. Amen. Amen. And now, letter T, God looks for a heart that trusting God's will with all of our heart. Do you trust God, kapatid? Do you trust God? Sabi sa Isaiah 55:8-9, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Wag po natin unahan ang Panginoon, because ang kanyang thoughts ay higher than sa atin. So can we trust God even when things are not going our way or hindi po talaga naayon sa plano natin? Can we trust God if He answers our prayers in ways that is contrary to our prayers? Do you will still trust God? Amen. So, in my walk with God, I learned that if I cannot understand His plans, if I cannot see His hands or if I cannot see his hands, rather, I learn to trust his heart. So let's learn to trust his heart, kapatid. Kahit hindi po natin nakikita ang Panginoon, kahit hindi po natin nararamdaman minsan, but still, let's trust his heart. Amen. Do you know that when we trust in God with all of our hearts, even our prayers will change? Hindi na po ito makasarili. Hindi na lang po ito me, I, and myself. Ito po yung prayer that changed our heart. To pray for others. To pray for what's God's plan for us. Last 3 years ago, tama ba? Last 3 years ago, I was struggling. Everything, my spiritually, emotionally, hindi lang halata. Because of my work. Diba dito, we need to have sometimes, if you are in a medical field, you need to have a certification, you need to have na you have a board exam, that you your license, diba? That job, I really tell that God given that job for me. Because I'm not in a medical field. I'm not a medical student. But when time goes by, learning a lot of things, new things, God put me in that position even without certificate. It's like I'm doing that for 13 years. Wag niyo nang tanungin kung hanggang kailan pa ako dito or kailan ako dumating dito sa UAE. So 13 years of doing that job without certificate. It's like, wow. It's amazing. God really protecting me. A job stability. We're praying for that, right? Especially here. We are OFWs and expats, right? Kahit anong maisip nila, they can fire us. But this job is really, God put me on that job. Why? I'm asking the Lord, Lord, bakit ito ang trabaho ko? Hindi ko naman to inaral. Diba? And that I knew, it's a harvest field. That God gave me a chance to share His word to my colleagues. And that time, medyo shaking na ako dahil they're asking about certification. Do you know that there is a mass termination? 5 times, kapatid, 5 times. But God really put me in a place that hindi niya tayo tatanggalin. Amen. So how amazing the Lord sa buhay ko that time na sa ginagawa kong trabaho. So, the time has come to get that certification or that examination. Hindi ka ganun kadali. But I took it 5 times. 5 times. I took it 5 times. Ang sakit po sa bulsa. But sabi nga nung isang kaibigan ko, bibigyan ka ni Lord. Ipro-provide ni Lord lahat. Right? Yung lahat ng iyong mga fee, ibibigay ni Lord. Sabi nga, trust God's will. Diba? Trust in the Lord. And that time, God changed my prayer. Because previously, para saan ba talaga tong certificate na to? It's only for myself, para maging stable ako sa work ko. So God changed my prayer. At that fifth examination, before taking up that exam. Kasi nga naiya na ako, pang fifth time na. Minsan sa prayer request, hindi ko na pinare-request. Naiya na po ako eh. Pero you know, ang sabi ng Lord, isama mo kasi ako. Isama mo ko. And that time, God changed my prayer and how I pray. Sabi ko, Lord, pang fifth time na. Paano po tayo tatagal sa UAE? Tayo. So that's the time ang hinihintay ni Lord to give him also a chance na makasama niya pala ako doon sa journey ko. Amen? Because five times. But don't give up, sabi nga. Huwag po tayong hihinto. Huwag po nating hintuan kung ano yung dapat na para sa Panginoon. Because it will never be in vain, kapatid. Amen? Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. And lo and behold, pumasa po tayo. Amen! Praise God. And that, until now, because I changed places or I changed the facility dahil po ako yung nagtatrabaho sa hospital. Dahil po doon at dahil po sa Diyos na buhay, ay meron pa rin po tayong trabaho. At tayo po ay ginagamit ng Panginoon hanggang ngayon. Amen. Palakpakan po muli natin ang Panginoon. Habi nga, ako po ay makasalanan noon, pat ngayon nagpupuri sa Panginoon dahil sa lahat ng pong ginawa niya sa atin. At ngayon, ako po si Pastora Ana Tamaray, nagbibigay po ng mensahe at ng galing sa Panginoon. At lahat po ng yun ay ibinabalik ko po sa Kanya. And in closing, yes! Closing na! Kapatid, gising ka na ba? So in closing, it's not enough for us just to believe and have faith, but we need to show our faith with love in action. Amen. So yung mga, di ba, yung mga nanligaw, yung mga nanligaw dyan, di ba, they did in action just para masuyo, di ba, suyuin yung girl na kanilang gusto. Diba? So it's the same thing. We need an action. So the faith of sinful woman creates a big impact to many on how to honor and value our Savior even to this present time. Amen. So value Him. Respect Him. Honor Him, love Him from the heart, kapatid. Amen. From the heart. Hallelujah. And for this challenge, ang tanong ko po, kita ang puso mo, kapatid. Praise God. Tara, ayusin natin ang puso natin. So remember that in everything that we do, especially if it's for Him, always check our hearts. Amen. So in memory verse, Jesus said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace, kapatid." Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Praise God. We praise and glorify God for that message. It was a refreshing and beautiful message. Palakpakan po natin ulit yung Panginoon sa buhay ng ating messenger for today, Pastora Ann. Thank you so much. May we invite the congregation to please stand up. Wow. Jesus said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. You may go in peace." You know, many people may be riding a beautiful car. They may be living in a luxurious place. They may even be enjoying what the world can offer them. But do they really have that peace in the heart? I remember one time I was working with this guy. I was in Qatar. He was earning literally 20,000 dirhams per day. Oh, kada sasampa siya sa offshore, ang rate niya umakit ng 20,000 dirhams. Pero tuwing mag-uusap kami, ang nadidinig ko sa kanya, what I hear from him, what I receive from him is always fear, anger, and disgust. Not only sa trabaho, he disgusts his life, he disgusts his wife, he disgusts his son. I just bought him an expensive sports car. Ngayon tumatawag siya, he wants to sell his car. There is no joy anymore. Here, God assured the woman that you may go in peace. All your transgressions, I remove them. Sabi ng Psalms kanina, how far was the removal? As far as the east to the west. Napakasarap po noon, mga kapatid. And what we're going to do now is thank you, Paz. Is we're going to remember what God did for us. He gave up His glory to be sacrificed on the cross. I remember those words. Now is the time for the Son of God to be glorified. Those was some of the last words that Jesus Christ told His disciples before He was taken by the Roman soldiers. While remembering those words, alam niyo mga kapatid, inaalala ko, was there glory in the crucifixion? Was there glory when Jesus Christ was spat on the face, He was slapped on the face, and He was disgusted by the Roman soldiers? Was there glory in there? Wala akong maalalang glory doon eh. But then I remembered, the glory was because He did His purpose for His Father. Nagawa ko yung gagawin ng Panginoon. If you're going through situations right now, it may be a difficult situation. If your heart, yung inyong puso, ay nagpapasalamat at nagpupuri sa Diyos, there is glory in there, mga kapatid. Just like what the preaching was telling us. Let us pray po for the elements that we're going to partake. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord God, for the love that you had expressed, that you have shown us. Thank you for the sacrifice, Father, that gave us an opportunity to be your children, to embrace the promise that one day we will be with you in paradise when we pass on to the next part of our existence. 2,000 years ago, when the Lord Jesus Christ walked on the face of the earth, the night before the Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, the night the Lord Jesus Christ was, before the Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, he was with his disciples. He took bread. He prayed to the Father, gave the bread to his disciples and said, "Take this bread, all of you, and eat this. This is my body, which will be given up for you." Let us partake of the bread. In the same manner, when the supper was ended, again, he took the cup. He gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this cup, all of you, and drink from it. This is my blood, blood of the new covenant, which is given up for you. Every time you eat this bread and partake this cup, you proclaim the death and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ." Let us partake of the cup. Good and faithful Father, we are grateful beyond words for that love that you have expressed to us. Lord, we will honor you and we will always choose to trust you and give glory to your name. Yes, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Maraming salamat po. Pwede na po kayong magsiupo as we welcome our VIPs. Yan. Ulit po, magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. And good morning din po sa mga VIPs natin dyan. Baka po may mga first-timers sa mga ating mga online po na mga viewers. Welcome po sa ating service ngayon. This is all for Christ Church International Abu Dhabi. Maraming salamat po for joining us in the service. Maybe call dito po sa harapan ng ating mga VIPs, si Shailene, si Yubu, si Rose Jane, and si Melchor. Palakpakan po natin yung Lord sa kanilang buhay. Ayan. Pwede pong malaman yung inyong mga pangalan at sino yung nag-invite at saka kung saan po kayo sa Pilipinas.
Ako po si Jenny Lynn. At in-invite po ako ni Ate Rachel. Tapos sa Pampanga po ako.
Brother Lord. My name is Yubuta Kanyebwa, and I was invited by my friend Ronald, and I thank God to be with him here.
Hello po, ako po si Melchor. In-invite po ako ni Allen, taga Bulacan po.
Hello po, ako po si Rose. In-invite po ako ni Allen at Negros Occidental po.
Hello po. Good morning po. Ako po si Shailene. In-invite po ko ni Ate Diana Rose Cavico po.
Yan. Palakpakan din po natin yung mga nag-invite sa kanila, mga kapatid. Thank you. You know what? Let me say this. Those people who invited you, they value your relationship with them and they value you so much. Why? Because they don't want to be with you here only. They want you to experience the faithfulness and goodness of our living, loving, and holy God. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Amen. Yan. This is all for Christ po. And allow us naman po to welcome you to our family.
Welcome to the family. We're glad that you have come to share your life. Each other more.
God. Palakpakan po natin sila ulit. Maraming maraming salamat po. Church, let us all stand up for our closing prayer. I'm sure we are all recharged, refreshed, encouraged, and may we bring the message. Kung na-bless po kayo dun sa message na dineliver ni Pastora Ann, I tell you this, the true fruit of that blessing will start as you step out of this place. Let us all together bow our heads and praise and thank our living, loving, and holy God. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord God, for that victorious worship service that you have allowed us to experience this morning. Thank you for the messenger, Lord God, na dinala mo po sa aming harapan. Bless her. Bless Pastora Ann Tamaray, Lord Father. Continue to use her mightily. Allow her to experience more testimonies in her life. Allow her to learn more, to trust you, and be fully dependent on you. Salamat po, O Diyos, dahil in spite of her weaknesses, in spite of the failures that she has gone through, in spite of the many things na pinagdaanan niya sa buhay, this has turned around to make her a strong and faithful servant of yours, Lord God. May she continue to bless other people, continue to be conduit of your goodness and faithfulness sa buhay ng mga taong nakapaligid sa kanya. Ganon din po yung panalangin namin, O Diyos, sa bawat isa, sa bawat kapatid namin, nakasama namin sa bulwagang ito, ngayong umagang ito. Patuloy mo silang pagpalain, O Diyos. Tulungan mo kaming magtiwala sa iyo. To trust you and to rest in the promise that our God never changes His promise. You are the same God yesterday, today, and forever. And we declare that we sit in a strong foundation because our Father embraces us more than anything else. Mga kapatid, may you please raise your hands. Please raise your hands. Heavenly Father, raise these hands that are raised right now. Bless these people, Lord God. Allow them, Lord God, to experience the fullness of your protection, love, guidance, and your favor over their life. Favor over authority and men. Favor over their work. Wisdom and knowledge sa kanilang ginagawa, Lord, and bless them. Keep them away not only from the works of the enemy, Father, but keep them away from temptation and from sin. This we pray in Jesus' name, amen and amen.